Hello, hello, welcome back everybody. Me, Jackus D, and Grievous here.
Pop, pop, pop.
Holding it down on Ultra Street Fighter 4 today. We're going to have a Ram Robin. It's got four players, but they're all pretty good. Vertigo and Rem we know pretty well, and you do not observe he is in the bracket, but we know him as Wonder Horse, and Urban Charmander, who's new to our tournament, so should be a good tournament today. Let me just call first games in our Discord and we should be able to get underway.
Pog, 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 pog. I'm interested to see if we're going to see any El Fuerte, good old Vertigo, or if we're just going to see it again, you know.
Yeah, this is it. Urban Charmander said earlier in Discord, please no again.
I
guess he knows of it, maybe, yeah. Now that Vertigo's been in that smug video.
Esports made it. You know, it's Gen's ass. You're Gen's ass. It's all right. I guess. All right.
Okay, yeah. So first up on stream, it should be SMBF Vertigo versus Urban Charmander. Be first to three sets throughout the round robin. So should see some good stuff. Like you say, we might be seeing Gen or possibly El Fuerte from Dave. But I'm pretty sure we can run the game at 60 FPS now, so we should be going Gen. Apparently that was the reason he was using El Fuerte in that one the other day we ran. And Urban Charmander? I've no idea who he uses. Maybe Fire? I'm saying Ken. What's your pick for Urban Charmander?
I didn't even hear what you said. My mic like this.
Oh. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, I'm saying we're going to get the usual from Dave from Vertigo probably, but I don't know who we're going to get for Urban Charmander, and I'm calling Ken because of the fire.
Oh, I see. Charmander, Kenneth Masters.
Who knows?
There's a lot of characters, man.
There is.
I'm going to call, I want to say, Bison. No.
Oh, he says he doesn't play Shoto in the chat, so
okay,
still a mystery.
I want to say, Dudley, but, nah. Feilong? No. I wonder. I'm curious. I don't care that much, to be honest. I'm intrigued, but you know.
Yeah, I'm intrigued. Regardless, whoever it is, I'm sure it'll be a good set.
How do these guys know who you play? Why do I not know who you play? Why do you know these guys? But you don't know me, man. What the hell?
I'm the legendary
Grievers. Okay, I'm the best Valentino in Europe. Trademark. All right, dude.
Well, that would be good sets then if they know who you play. Hopefully you've played them before and we'll see some good stuff. What's going on, God? Are we getting there, God?
Vertigo playing El Fuerte and Gen. We have Rem playing typically exclusively E Honda. I know he does play Kami a little bit, but that's very specific matchups. But usually he plays free Honda. You don't observe, which we know him as Wonder Horse.
Yeah. Wonder Horse.
No idea what character.
Well, I'm thinking Guile because he plays exclusively Guile as far as I know in 5. So I would have thought Guile because Guile's good in 4 as well, right?
And then Urban Charmander, which we don't know who they're playing yet.
We're about to see. I missed it. Then if it should.
Imagine Rem calling me out and imagine calling me out. I was going to say Ibuki. That was going to be my first
Ibuki,
pick. I didn't want to say it, but also imagine calling me out, Bell. But you suck at team, bro.
Oh God, we haven't got a stream, by the way. We're looking at the stream, not a
calling me out in SF4. Everyone knows I'm literally the best player in our Discord at SF4. What?
Thank you very much.
All right. So Ibuki versus Gen. So this match was basically whoever gets knocked down loses the game. Typically, it can be really bad for Gen purely for the fact he has like very low health and very low stuff. I mean, Ibuki basically has the same. Gets hit with a kunai in front. DP, decent damage there. Get hit with the waterfall kicks. Now you got a guess. Let's raise your gun.
Ooh.
A cross up a whip.
That's a grab.
Cross up. Oh, that hit in front. Oh, just a jab? Why? Why, man? Why do it to yourself? Oh, now you got to deal with Ibuki's pressure.
Yeah.
Oh,
I think Vertigo's pretty familiar with Ibuki stuff.
Oh. Ben. Oh. Oh. Oh, but doesn't care. ESDP, get off me.
I don't know how much Dave plays Ibuki in this game, but I've seen a lot of Ibuki in 5 from Dave, so I think he's probably dabbled with a lot of the cast in this, obviously. But...
Yeah. I mean, the thing is with Ibuki in this game is basically you just have to learn, get adjusted to Aura's set play. That's the hardest part. Also, I think that setup he's doing there might not work on Ibuki. She might be a smaller body, but I mean, I imagine he probably knows way more than me. That's probably what he's trying to do. Maybe it's just harder to do on her because she is a smaller body, so... No FADC there. I wonder why. Probably just, well, now he's got a super, right? So a super ultra will kill her if he does it from like one or two hits.
Yeah, he's got his win condition.
Yeah, literally. Oh, the jump. Oh, wow. Ooh. Oh, that's death.
Yeah.
You know, it's very rare you see that move from Ibuki, but that's like some first strike stuff, man. Jeez.
Yeah, that was like a first strike finish when she's literally using that super.
Right, so still has a... Oh, just jump it. You're the SMBF Classic, they're jumping into throw.
Yeah, you know it.
Misses the cross-up again because of the delay tech. So get a knockdown here. Kunai set up. Yep, there's a jump in. There's a stand light kick to buffer for delay. Delay wake up. Just a sweep. Kunai. That hit. Pretty sure cross-up.
Does this stun not like this, Dave?
Okay, that was the whack. You know, everyone knew he was going to go for a set, but the fact he waited, and that was the deadest setup. Man's out here trying to flex, like... Oh, that didn't block that. And no combo, doesn't get the 2-frame link. Kunai's. And still, any side... Oh, a bit of lag. Oh, no. I mean, is he going to go for it?
Nice, and I think someone was lying to us. You were saying it was his first time playing.
I don't know how I feel about the raw EX neckbreaker there. Because if that didn't work, David would have won the game. Just super ultra would have killed there.
Yeah. Like you say, he had the win condition, but yeah. Urban Charmander looking super strong. Dave needs to adjust them fast. It's 1st to 3, so he's got a game still to go.
Yeah, looking a bit booky out here right now. I don't know if I'd say super strong. Definitely looking relatively strong with the Ibuki. Dropping a few links here and there. And definitely has some of the delay tech.
I think I'm taken by surprise because he was saying he was new in the Discord. He was
fam, that's a tech I use.
He lulled me into the full sense of security. I should have known.
That's a tech I use when people sit down at locals. Sit down at locals like, yeah, hey man, do you want to play? I'm like, yeah, I haven't played this game too much. And I body them free. Scumbag. Alright, so anyways, back into this explosive matchup.
Bit of a mess. He's threw the game away, but it's 1-0 to Urban Charmander right now.
I expect much better from David here, but he's getting decked, so...
Let's go, Dave.
Ooh, this should be
get a game on the board at least.
There we go. Gonna get a mix of here with a safe jump. Nice use of the delayed medium punch to try and catch a throw attack. Doesn't get an empty jump low.
Here we go.
Gonna get a knockdown here. This does hit in front. Ooh. Wow, the jab whipped over her there.
Yeah.
Oh, that was almost a sick counter hit confirm. Wow, just a lot of just fake pressure here. Get off me with
the DX kicks.
Time to guess. Where are we going? Out in front. That is -4, I believe. So, actually, Ibuki can punish that pretty hard.
Very low on life now. Where's the punish? It's the throw.
Yeah, Ibuki could probably punish that wall dive thing super hard because she could probably just do like crouching jab or standing jab into stand medium kick into a hard knockdown. So probably kind of a relatively risky option against Ibuki.
Catches him out of the air after he dives the wall.
Decent amount of chip damage being done here as well.
Yeah.
But we're getting close to that super mark for again. That's where he becomes, you know, much more of a scary character than he already is. Oh well, there it goes. FADC, but we get set up here. Cross up, nice. We get set up from this as well. Just jumps in front. Got DP Ender. Interesting. Rather than using the neckbreaker or the... Yeah, this... Well, I don't know what these kicks are called, but yeah, those kicks. Oof. And he does it again.
He's got it again.
He does it again. Not ready
for it. He likes that setup.
We are playing online. You know, we are playing online. I'm not sure if you can actually hit confirm it. I think you have to buffer off the second hit. So I'm not sure if you're going to hit confirm it. Because obviously, if you can't hit confirm it, then that's a pretty big gamble. But I'm pretty sure it's super safe anyway, so... It's not too much by gamble, but still, you don't lose all your meter.
Yeah, I like to see it. I only ever see that in third strike normally.
Damn, we're getting waxed out here. Should I join the tournament and body this guy or what?
Yeah, not like this, Dave. Turn it on.
Can I get in the tournament now? Can I in there and just body everyone? Or is that like, can I body everyone?
I mean, even if he loses this, it's a round robin. He might win every other game, and then he could possibly, if Urban Charmander loose drops the game, it'll be a.
Well, he's still lose.
He'll still lose. Yeah. Well, better pull it out now then.
Yeah, I mean, I expected better, man. I expected better, but here we are. Here we are, mate.
Who knows? There's two other people in this tournament as well, so.
So I'm liking this. I don't even know what animal that Kabuki costume is supposed to be. I'm also not liking the lack of neutral Charmander has here. You saw Thar, he walked himself into the corner for that very start of the round. Can't be doing that. You need to stand your ground. Yeah, same with the overhead. The second hit, the overhead, it is. There's a setup here. That hit across him. Now, I think I want to hit him front, actually.
Back to neutral.
It's hard to tell. Sweep. Gets nothing off it. Just gave her basically some free ultra meter. Cross up. That was definitely always going to be cross up there.
It's the kick. I'm thinking and low on life.
And that hit in front.
Finishes.
I believe that. I think that the dive kick off the wall, like that one, I think that one's safe. I think the other one is. No, that one's unsafe. I think that one's a -4. And the other one. Actually, I have no idea. I really should know all this stuff, mate. I play against this character all the time. I should know the frame data, but I just didn't. What they're like. Man backs up. Yeah, that's how you know he's got good sportsmanship. David just jumping towards him.
David just jumping in, yeah.
As it's towards you.
Yeah. Just do it.
Oh boy.
Just a second, go for it.
I think I hit here kills. Oh.
Ooh.
No.
There we go.
Thanks for polite.
And there's the ultra. I thought that was going to kill on its own, but he had the ultra on deck to take it.
Look what damage that did. Yeah. Like, Jesus Christ. Super and Ultra does so much damage. And the fact that it's like so easily accessible for like Gen, you can do it off like whiff punishes, you could do it off hands as a confirm. You could do supers are super good to be honest. Like it's fast. It can be used as an anti-air if you're in the other stance. And obviously, you even if you haven't got Ultra, you can still do waterfall kicks after it or do like a sweep. So like you get big damage and you get like a mix up after it, so.
Fair.
All right, so
Urban Charmander saying his luck of the character, he's pressing buttons. Well, I don't believe that right now.
To be fair, you are playing a Buki, so like, yeah. I mean, I could honestly, I could probably like pick a Buki. I mean, I've played a Buki before. Buki was like one of the first characters I've played on main, but like, I could probably play a Buki and like do just as well. Yeah, you just randomly knock down and throw kunais, man.
But convincing those first two games, Dave's turned up though. It was 2-1. Here we go into a. I mean,
it was convincing, mate. It was convincing. Look at Dave washing right now, mate.
Dave go right now, yeah.
Yeah, look at him go right now, mate. He's gonna knock him out. Here we go. Fighting on a boat. hold this sweep. Hold this kunai. Nice block. Wow, jump medium kick. Probably didn't want that.
Nah. Rolls.
Wow. Interesting.
Jumps over there. For some reason.
Probably wants to be looking for jumps. Both people probably be looking for jumps here. Yeah. Interesting punish there. Crouching medium punch into the roll. Set up. Cross up. Wow, that where did that even hit? Like jeez. Oh, the underhand. Kunai. Oh no. This is a Buki.
Momentum a shift, here we go. Ooh, EX is out and a block.
That's him in death. And it's just a random sweep. That should have been death on the punish there, but it just drops the combo.
Yeah.
It might be a luck of the character by looking at that, you know. No punish. Oh, did that combo? That would have been nutty, that combo, jeez. Cross up, blocks it. Alright, back to neutral. Rare footage of neutral.
Both down in full screen, yeah.
Yeah, neither of these characters play neutral, so. Oh, back throw, time to guess. Oh, misses it because of delayed wake up. Now, this is a scary situation because the super's on deck. Oh boy. That's why he keeps on committing to those crisis strongs into the hands.
Win conditions there.
Win conditions is most definitely there. Oh no. Oh, might have been able to super on the wake up there. Oh, that's big damage again. Huge damage. But,
don't jump.
Oh, nice tech.
Good stuff.
Oh. Getting close to chip now though. Oh, you know he's looking for it. He's looking for the jump in roundhouse because obviously it juggles into the ultra.
Yeah, good stuff. Kept him out. Sat on that life lead.
The winning condition's still there. It's still there. It's burning away right now. He's not gaining meter.
Oh, I don't think he's going to spend any of that bar. Oh, he spent a bit. God. Okay. He spent it. Yeah, it was worth it.
Ooh. It hits in front, but it crosses up.
Yeah.
Oh, you going to block this? Nope.
No, thanks for playing. And it's gonna be 2-2.
Damn, I'm kind of upset that Dave didn't do a red focus. there for extra damage. Needed a neutral jump, but you know, each turn. Right, so a perfect. My man's turning it around.
Yeah, turned it right.
You downloaded them?
Yeah, well, let's see. We might see more of those like sweet confirms into super if they are confirms or possibly not. But either way, they look sick.
Virgo was on the Wi-Fi earlier. Couldn't download him because it's too slow. Now he's plugged into the supercomputer. Got them download speeds ready to go.
It's the worst thing when you see your Monster Hunter download is finished. And you're like, oh, I was playing the whole time with download on shit.
Oh, yeah, it's like when I was playing on like my PS4 and like, I didn't have my Ethernet cable plugged into it. I'm just like, oh shit, oh, I've been playing this entire time with my Ethernet in. Like, god damn, what the hell's going on?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, or that, yeah, or that, yeah.
You have the Jeez. Option wrong, God was saying.
Why is that a thing? Why is it not just... Oh, no.
I'm sure you haven't.
Oh, no.
Here we go, early stuff.
There's a fake pressure with the command dashes.
Interesting. Overhead.
Interesting command dash there. Didn't really get too much from it, but went for the overhead. Works out. And this is going to be stun.
It's going to be stun any minute now. Oh, he just gets out.
Stun is now... Oh, that's going to work.
Is that going to work? Yeah, okay. Nice.
Corner landing lag.
Punish on the kunai. Set
from this. Cross up, yep. You see, once you play against this character so much, you can just identify where what's going to cross up and what's not. Yeah.
I haven't played Dave's game enough. He still washes me with all these cross ups.
Oh my god, DP. Yeah, you identify it by his jump trajectory as soon as he jumps, and also the stance he's in when he's in the air. It's kind of hard to explain, but you just base it off his jump trajectory, and you can see where it's going to cross up or not. I guess a roll. Probably be looking for a jump from Ibuki. Yep, there it was.
Ooh, oh god, the kunai catches him.
Not seeing too much of the set play that we were saying early on though.
No.
From Ibuki. All right, again, probably wants to be looking for that Ibuki jump. It's going to be coming. And there it is. I'm not sure if Gen could just EXDP through the kunai. I think Yeah, the kunai is a knife, right? So you can actually just jab it. Like, it doesn't have a fireable property, so.
I presume it's the same in this. You can do that in third strength. Oh, here we go, though. Time to get mixed.
I assume he doesn't have those.
Win condition.
There's a win condition.
Into ultra.
He top deck.
Yeah.
There you go. Thanks for playing.
A real good set. That was some good stuff. Virgo's going to take it 3-2 in the end.
Man got the pot agreed.
Well played from both players.
Top deck to Zodia.
Put that score in right here.
I feel like if my man could super jump cancel with Ibuki, super jump cancel into Ultra 2, that might have been a bit different, but either way, David caught his eye in the end. Thought he was going to go down for free, but back 3-2 instead.
It looked very worrying. Urban Charmander definitely looks like he knows some stuff with Ibuki. It was looking good. So we'll see how he fares in the next match. But she's not going to be for a little bit. Because next up we're getting Rem and You Do Not Observe, or Wonder Horse, as we know. Call that in the Discord.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I'm intrigued to see what characters we're gonna get because I don't know.
I think we're gonna see Honda versus Guile. That's what I'm calling. But that sounds horrible for Honda. I don't know that.
That is most definitely a bad matchup for Honda. But do you know how to play that matchup? It's easier said than done, just keeping Honda out.
Yeah.
Obviously, like, Honda can just neutral jump from Fierce, like, stop sign, like, over Sonic Booms and slowly move forward. And also, you need to have the correct anti-airs on deck with Guile. If you can consistently anti-air of, like, forward Fierce, down forward Roundhouse, you know, what kind of stuff. Also, just obviously Flash Kick and Crouch Fierce. Should be alright, but it's easier said than done. And obviously, if E-Honda does get in, then it can be a bit troublesome. You can't just do decent damage with hands into headbutts.
Yeah.
Also, there's the scenarios where if he just does headbutt, knocks you down, does headbutt again. I'm not sure what Guile's punish is on headbutt. I think maybe Flash Kick. Just raw Flash Kick. I think that's what Zane was doing, right? I think he's just doing raw Flash Kick to punish headbutts. I think Flash Kick is 5 frame, or at least in SF5 is 5 frame.
Yeah.
5 frame and then 4 frame for EX.
I think if we see Honda and he gets a life lead, we're going to see Bo sit on it for a bit, but how long can he sit there blocking booms is the thing. And he's going to have to...
No, that's what I'm saying. You can just neutral jump.
Okay, yeah. Right? He's going to have to do that then, yeah.
Or
yeah.
Jump back or 4 jump, you know.
He's going to have to be careful. He's going to have to be careful. Jumping too much. Like, you know.
Well, yeah, even if you're throwing booms anyways, you can just, you know, guess a boom and jump in, get a combo, so...
We got... you do not observe in the chat saying he doesn't have a main. He doesn't need one. And he
doesn't need
us.
One? Damn. Okay. We're going to this old man game though. This is the old man game. This is the game, you know, this is the game that everyone grinded and everyone got godlike at, you know. This was the real competition. This is what I put so much time into, man. God damn.
Yeah. Yeah, when I first started coming to weeklies offline, this was the main game there, having sort of just taken off from
the only
first
game
strike.
There. The only game.
I was going to say that. It was the anime corner, which I was a part of for quite a long time before I took up SO4 with the rest of the anime
anime games. Two like subs anime games.
That's it. Yeah. Lots of Guilty Gear Sign when it was first out. When I first started going to offline.
Alright, so I'm going to see Evil Ryo from Ram. Definitely seen him play Evil Ryo every now and then. probably not his best character, obviously. E-Honda definitely is, but makes his matchup a lot easier than what it is. We'll see how good my man's Guili is in 4. Gaol, a completely different breed in this game than he was in 5. A lot of his moves are very different. They operate different. But Guile in this game can definitely be played hyper-aggressive, which is typically a style in 5.
That's it. When I think of 4, I think of those like old aggressive American Guile players, like Knuckle-Doo and Dominion.
Dominion was like the defensive one. They play opposite the spectrum. So.
Yeah.
But I don't think this matchup is terrible for... wow, he just did it. He could have got a DP after that as well. I don't think this matchup is terrible for Guile, but it's definitely not in his favor, I don't think. But, you know, wow, Red Focus committed.
Very close on life right now, and Wonderwall takes a first round.
You notice how my man did that from standing, you know? My man did that from standing. Garl's low tier? Yeah, Garl's low tier. I mean, actually, no, Garl's at mid tier. I would say he's low tier. Garl's definitely, like, not terrible. But he has a variety of bad matchups, but, you know. But I don't think Garl doesn't do too bad against Shoto's, so, you know. Evil Ryu, perhaps, just for the fact he has so much damage, and Evil Ryu's low forwards, like, honestly, one of the most stupid moves in the game, but... Either way.
Just backdash and fireballs, there's a dive kick.
Flash kick, we're gonna get a decent Punisher. Wow.
No, not really.
interesting.
Bo, we said it before, we'll say it again, pick your mains.
Alright, here we go, decent Punisher. Drops the 2-frame link and just does a DP, the classic. The classic. You do the same thing with Akuma. When you drop the Tatsu link, you just do a DP after, keep him in check. Alright, so
Ren taking the second round, Matt.
Sonic boom.
Sonic. I mean, we haven't got sound effects. I feel like I haven't got audio on the stream anyway.
I can't hear either. So. Alright, 4-throw. Where's the setup? Wow, that was the most delayed. That was so unsafe. Mm-hmm.
Gets the read on the
empty jump low. Doesn't get the combo down.
Ooh, Sonic Boom that time.
Flash kick. Could have maybe got a Ultra 2 off that, but wasn't ready for it.
Oh, I don't know what that was. I think he was trying to Sonic Boom and fucked up in some way because he got a jump on that punish.
All right. Probably looking for the Ultra 2 right now.
Oh, there's a DP.
Nice, he knew
he was looking for that jump.
Yeah, crouch, and DP there.
So Rem gonna take
the as well. Wasn't really using too much meter, probably because he hasn't got the FADC combos on deck with Evil Ryo.
Yeah. Rem gonna take the first game there, God. Yeah.
Even then, I guess the best thing to do is just if you're not gonna be using a meter for FADC combo because you're not too confident in yourself, the best thing to do with Evil Ryo especially is just literally just low forward fireball FADC. Like hit confirm the low forward fireballs, FADCs into big damage. That's basically the best option you really have if you can't do all the optimal axe kick loops and stuff like that. So.
Oh, I want to see axe kick loops, sir.
Yeah, I mean, but my man's got combos. What do you think he plays E-Honda? Yeah. He plays E-Honda and he's a Street Fighter 5 player. He plays Colleen. Come on, man. Can't do combos. Ooh, Kenneth Masters.
Oh, we got Zane talking that good stuff in the chat.
Damn. We're calling. Okay, I see you. All right. We call him Man's Out. Man's Out here trying to have fun with his main from 5.
Oh, yeah, Ken. Okay. I respect the change. He says he plays... Yeah. I mean, he's more of a... It's a lot more SF5, I think.
Your goal's looter, bro. All right. Grass.
I think Wonderhorse is decent. He's played a lot more SF5 and leveled up a lot in that game. So, see how he does in 4 and what he's learned so far.
So, then that's Axe Kick on block. Bo's going to do a DP after. Watch, I guarantee you. Oh, fireball. That was definitely... Oh, wow.
Thrown out. EX DP. That was
definitely unsafe.
Going to get a nice punish. Got a punish.
It was not bad. Maybe went for a DP, but didn't get it.
Ooh, thrown out again. Waiting that time.
Wow, we're dropping all kinds of combos here. Boy, look at the spacing. Look at the spacing. Knows the spacing. Rising jab anti-air. That's the marks of a Street Fighter 5 player.
All right.
Gets fireable. Close to ship here. DP. Mm. Ready for it. Ready for it. Ready for it.
In those situations, you just got to be careful about those jumps a lot more. Seen it last couple of rounds. I think 5's a lot more heavy jump game in general, right? Risk reward wise, so.
Oh, yeah, totally. I mean, it's somewhat. It's just like. I don't know. I don't want to get into that.
Yeah, okay. Don't worry.
It's just you have more options in 4 to deal with jump ins, I guess. So it's pretty easy to deal with jump ins a lot of the time. Alright.
Nice. Ooh, gets the anti air, keeps in the corner.
Could have got a fierce DP after that light DP.
Ooh, goes for DP again.
Oh my god. We've got
demons.
I can't believe you just did that even on hit. That's nutty.
Missats.
That's nutty. My man dropped the combo, walked up and did demon. You know? Like he could have killed with the combo, but he thought, nah, bun that. Alright, so 2 on the board.
2 on the board. Are we going
to go back to the Geely? Yeah, definitely think we should go back to the Gar. I think the Gar was definitely.
I think the Gar was more solid, yeah. It was more ready, more accustomed to the booms and the flash kicks, just because of all that Guile play.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, certain things are different.
I'm not going to sing the song, because God will kill me.
So. My man dipped on it. Your Street Fighter Fire is a scrub-friendly game, perfect for me. You realize, Zane, bam, oh, body you, man, what do you mean? Are you going to cuss me out? Jeez. You realize I stopped playing 5 like, ages ago, like, bro.
I'm godlike, you realize that? Yeah, Zane, the resident shit talker. Yeah, I like everyone thought I was bad for shit talking, but like Zane is renowned for shit talking. You know, my man's straight hating out here.
There's somebody left and they shouldn't have. I think. Yeah, Wonder Horse.
We need a Wonder Horse to get back in here. First to freeze, man. First to freeze. Oh man, yo, Zane started cussing man's out. Man had the audacity to call, like, to complain about Matera in Grand Blue when you play Lancelot, bruh. Are you gonna complain about Matera, dude? Come on, man.
I got faith. I think Wonder Horse is gonna at least get on the board.
Oh yeah, I have faith. I mean, is Garl?
I think Garl's definitely strong. Yeah.
It's just certain things he's not familiar with in this. In this game, so to speak.
Yeah.
Just doing crouch jab into crouch strong into flash kick as an ender rather than sonic booms. you can get certain things in the corner with sonic booms, but it's better to just do, like, you know, the normal rights. But down forward heavy kick is a pretty good anti-air in this game, and it's fairly quick, so you can do down forward heavy kick into flash kick for anti-air, which does like a decent like 200 damage or so. Forward fares for longer anti-airs, if they're like further away and they're trying to do neutral jump, keep them in check.
Fair.
Standing roundhouse is pretty good in this game. Yeah, upside down kick's also okay. Also, imagine saying everyone's crap. Come on, man. Your ass.
Come on, man.
Your ass, alright? I ain't trying to hear that.
Hopefully, next time it's on Zane, you'll enter as well, because I enjoyed seeing your play in this game as well, so yeah, it'll be cool. Hopefully we'll have a big turnout next time we run this on PC or something.
Yo, is angry Ryu versus good Ryu? Violence is who I am. Wow, how edgy. So Shaz is just wolf costume, and Ryu is actually one of the 6 costumes. Like, I actually really like this costume. But they're both white. They're both you know, white and black. They're contrasting each other.
This is true.
Trying to fight a stand medium kicks. It's not too bad of at all. But this matchup definitely goes in favor of evil Ryu. Obviously, just better low forward. Low forward into fireball always works from every range. More damage, better combos.
Yeah. We want to see less jumps, but that worked that time.
Ryu can win it. There's some notable Ryu players who are not too bad at this matchup, but most of the Ryu players switch to evil Ryu anyway, so yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, gets a focus crumple. Jump in Tatsu. Yes, Fireball gonna land on it. Yep, there you go. dive kick, and dive that's kick a combo.
Finishes it out. That's a shame. Like, Wonder Horse was well up in the set there for a while. He just needs to close it out, but just sit on that life lead and wait for the jump.
Yes, horrible.
When you got the life lead, definitely.
Both players are like little to no meter. Doesn't get the anti air there. Wow, just forward throw, walk forward. No Okazemi. It's not done with the yet fireable. Low forward into the sweep. Low forward fireable. Fireable trades here. Rear does.
Good
Rear
old
does
fireball.
Rear does tend to have a better fireable than Evil Rear. Somewhat. It's like faster. He's got like better recovery and stuff like that, but.
Yeah, Wonder Horse well up in the set right now.
Real old school. We're getting
taking it back. Anyway. We're SF2 right now. Let's go.
Literally. All right, Christ, strong to take the rank. We're still holding on. We're holding on. Yeah, it's fireable. It's not down.
Ooh, gets an axe kick.
Yeah, it's fireable.
Even on life, just trading.
Oh, I can land on the fireball. Yeah. Oh, that's big
blow
damage.
For blow. It's got a corner.
Well, yeah, it's fireable. Keeping the stun up. Probably about 700, 800 right now. Stun's going now. Buffering something.
Yeah. Ooh. I think he's looking for
maybe
the jump.
An ultra.
Maybe. Oh, yeah, maybe.
Trades for the fireball and just gets every bow there.
And Rem's going to take it. I mean, the Ryu was looking like an almost decent pick there. Like, when it keeps it fundamental with the fireballs and the anti-airs.
Well, yeah, that's what you can do in this game. That's the beauty of this game, right? Is you can actually just play with you can play with your fundamentals, and you can play like a very basic game, and it can work out. Unlike a game like SF5, where the game just completely doesn't reward you for being remotely fundamentally strong, it rewards you for being an idiot and jumping around like a complete goofball. And you know,
so we're gonna get next is gonna be Vertigo versus Wonder Horse, who we just saw.
Okay. Wonder if we see the Guile. I don't imagine if Wonder Horse hasn't played four too much, he's probably not going to know the Gen matchup too well, which is kind of bad for him. But we'll see what he knows about Gen. I feel like I know Gen like inside and out at this point. I've played this character like 5,000 times.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen it so much from Vertigo over the years, and it's definitely his main. Puts that work in. It's good stuff.
Could pick out Forte, to be honest, you know.
Yeah. I know you've played this game a lot and dabbled with a lot of the cast, so yeah, obviously you can pick who he wants, really.
We will see. So I'll wait for...
So we sent the invite out. We're going to get set play. It's going to be Vertigo versus Wonder Horse. 3 out of 5. I suspect we're going to get Gen versus Guile.
We might. I feel like might be better pick a show.
I mean, this is a classic. I like seeing these two fight in SF5 because it's a lot more of a grudge match in 5.
Yeah, for sure. But obviously here, the experience might triumph over, you know, the rookie.
Yeah.
Obviously, Dave has probably like 7,000 hours in this game. I don't know, maybe like 5,000, split in between there somewhere. I mean, I know I have like 4,000, maybe like 3. I'll probably have like 3.5, maybe 4,000 hours in this game.
Yeah.
Yes. Elfwoodie and E Honda. All right. I mean, I respect it.
Yeah, let's see what happens.
This matchup, I don't know if Elfwoodie can punish Headbutt. I don't think he can punish Headbutt. I don't think he has anything long range that goes that far and fast.
I think Dave is going to be going ham. I think Vertigo is just going to be.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Okay.
I also don't know if. Wow, that fierce did so much damage.
He's keeping him out right now, though. Good stuff.
I'm not sure if Honda can punish Q-Bomb. Maybe with just Headbutt? I don't even know. Also, we got footage of banned colors. 11 and 12 banned.
It's fine.
Working out for Wonder Horse right now. Doing things, just playing extremely lame with the...
Exactly, yeah, just keep him out. Dave's going to go ham. Just keep him out with some fundies. Oh, little teabag going on right now. I like it.
Keep up with the headbutts. Oh, this could be the start of something now.
Ooh.
Has to be looking for the neutral jumps. Yeah,
Keep it solid. Jumps. Look out for it. Oh, no.
No. Burr, 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 burr. That's a classic, like, hey, I'm going to do this. And, like, basically, David was giving away that game. Like, he, if he got anti-aired or like he knew strike whatever, he didn't care. He gave away the game at that point, but it worked out. Alright, it's Q-bomb. Q-bomb again. Jumping Rhinos.
Now Babe's going to try run away a bit.
Oh, gets the hands. Doesn't hold forward with the hands, though. Oh, drops the combo.
Applying the pressure.
That's Waker, going to whiff, but he's not going to get a punish.
And a whiff, no punish, full screen. Both of them.
He gets headbutt. Oh, headbutt gets beaten out again. Or might have went for the fierce, actually. And the body splash. Q-bomb. FADC into nothing. Goes for the anti. Oh, wait a minute.
The command grab. Oh, wow, I would have done it again. I would have command grabbed again.
I think he did wake up Ultra. I think he did wake up Ultra and he got Rhinehouse. All right, crouching light kick, crouching light kick. Gets the Rhine. We're on the board. I mean, look, the title is You Shall Not Pass. That's why you pick E Honda. All right, crouching strong. He gets hands. Doesn't get the combo off of it, though. Yeah, I'm not sure what the punish is on Q-bomb. It might be just like headbutt. Or like EX headbutt. EX headbutt's kind of quicker, so.
Yeah.
Is that gonna work? It does. Okay, good to know. Decent damage. Alright, Q-bomb's out. Oh, God. Ooh. Not like this. Oh, boy.
Teabag into graphs.
El Fuerte. Yeah, my man did Q-bomb on your wake up. Not even EX, just did it. I don't know how I feel about that. Brab, brab.
One
now. How about a cactus pear? What else? A cactus pear?
I feel like we should see the Guile. I mean, I don't know.
I mean, Guile versus El Fuerte is not great.
Okay, fair enough.
Not great for Gwili, you know. But hey. Your Elf players? Your El Fuerte is great, man. El Fuerte is great. El Fuerte is a great... Put El Fuerte in SF5, even. I'm down.
You're down for that? I don't think I am.
I'm down. I didn't play the game. I don't care.
I don't either, but I still rather see, like, Oro and third strike characters.
No. Jack, the whole point of SF5, you don't want them to see... You don't want to see...
Okay, I suppose you don't want them ruined.
You don't want them to put your characters in the game. That's the whole point. Like, people are like, yo, put Rolento in. Like, I'm like, no, I don't want Rolento in that game. See, like... If your cards are like Fei Long and Sea Viper, please do not put them in 5. Don't ruin them, man. Like, actually, Fei Long, yeah, I didn't mind. Sea Viper, oh, please, 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 don't ruin Sea Viper. Oh my god. Sea Viper is so cool in SF4 and also Marvel 3. And like, okay, for them to ruin such a cool archetype, I can't deal with it.
I can understand that standpoint. Excuse me.
So, here we go. Gone to the real. This matchup is, I mean, I guess a little bit better than the E-Honda matchup, but still not so great. El Fuerte is... I feel like El Fuerte is very underrated, especially in this version of the game. That's going to work. That was a crouch light kick. Yep, decent damage here. Guess it's not bang. What's the Okazumi going to be? The Okazami, the Okazumi, the Okazumi. Wow, standing fierce. Just rolls to... Oh,
no. Oh.
That might have been an ultra attempt, but dropped it.
We're on the laggiest stage as well. I like, you love to see it.
Was that the DP air throw, but just it didn't work out?
Don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. It might have traded. I think that is a thing that happens.
Raw DP.
A lot of those DPs, yeah. Sweep. Another DP. They should be punishing that.
Ooh, wait, we're looking like Gandhi right now.
You know that video? Like, oh, yeah. God. Jeez, yeah, we saw 5 DPs in a row and it worked out. So, you know. Right, lots of runs. EXQ bomb, no punish. And that was a command throw splash, which is why it didn't work.
DPs again, nice. Oh, that's command
right
there.
That shit right there is really dumb. I don't know. What yeah. Q-bomb. Yeah, definitely need more DPs. More DPs, more Tatsus, you know. That's what we need. More DPs, more Tatsus. Oh my god, you woke up Q-bomb. Look how much damage it did. Jesus Christ. Oh, there's a Tatsu. It works.
Yeah. Neutral jump.
Random DP.
Oh, managed to block, but he got a little run stop fierce for his trouble.
Oh boy.
And there's the ultra. Did he jump over? Yeah, okay. We're gonna get.
I thought he was mid run.
Dave, come on, give us more run stop faces than that.
He's struggling, man. Oh, yes, run. U bomb. Wow, get out of the air. Get out of the air. Give me that head. Bruh.
All right, Dave's Vertigo is going to take it. 3-0. Wonder Horse, you do not observe. He's holding his own, doing what he can, moving around the cast. But yeah.
That's two.
Is that two?
I think it's two. Yeah, right. He played E-Honda, and then
Okay, that's just two then.
Yeah, I'm hearing a lot of nonsense in the chat right now. What I'm hearing. I'm hearing a lot of nonsense right now. Everyone's just speaking a bunch of nonsense to one another about a bunch of shite.
Yeah, yeah. It's because I looked at the overlay and it said two, but I assumed that two wasn't there a minute ago.
Oh, yeah.
We've
got a bunch of Street Fighter players.
My bad.
We've got a bunch of Street Fighter players, but half of these guys play Street Fighter 5 now, not Street Fighter 4 anymore.
They play 5. They're not in today's bracket.
We got Street Fighter 4 players cussing out Street Fighter 5 players. Which is kind of embarrassing, really, because I mean, like, hey, these guys are just coming back to play our game, you know? We should be appreciative that they're even playing our dead game.
Yeah, yeah. I appreciate the sign-ups, whoever they are. You know, anyone watching this, if you're UK-based, open free sign-ups for any of our tournaments.
Yeah, like this old or new player,
come and...
This game is hella dead, so we should be appreciative that anyone's coming back to play it, especially players from older games, newer games even. You know, it's the same thing like me going back to playing First Strike. It's just, you know, just nice to have, you know, new influx of the new blood, or else the games would just literally die. Well, anyways, decent round start by David there. Did get the stun, but dropped the run stop fierce combos. And a body splash to finish it off there. Looks like he put the pad down, maybe. Just accepted defeat.
Random select tournament, Zane said. Yeah, maybe one day. Nope. For Christmas.
Random still in lockdown. It's not a good idea purely for the fact that there's most of us here know how to play like half the cast anyways. And you get into grand finals and you lose literally because you get a character you don't know play. Like, if I get given like Gen or anyone has hands, like E-Honda, I play E-Honda. But like, they get like a character they're really good with and I get a character that I'm bad with, and that's just the luck of the draw. I'm not really down for that. And well, I was saying that.
Okay. Bam, bam. Yeah. Run stop first.
Yeah. Bam,
bam. But as I was saying, when I was mistaken before, it is now 3-0.
Yeah, Bo hyping himself up in SF5. Imagine. Yeah, Bo, it's impressive that you're the best SF5 player when there's about two people who play it in Bristol, you know.
Well, next up, we're going to get Urban Charmander versus Ren.
Pog, 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 pog.
I keep nearly adding the wrong tag, because Bo is in our Discord twice.
Kick the other one out, you know?
Yeah, I think you should do.
Yeah. I play all characters except from, like, piano characters. I don't know who else. I don't know. I basically play every character. I mean, it's not hard, really. When you played this game for like 15 years, it's not hard. I random set tournament is pointless. It's not. It's just because it's just basically luck based. It's like completely random. Like, that's, I guess it's a point, but like, it's not fun for me. I'd rather just pick my shit and just do what I'm doing, you know.
Well, hopefully we get a good turnout on PC next time we run this. It'll probably be on PC because we've done PS4 this time. And I know there's a fair few people with this on PC because it's been on Steam for a long time.
Hopefully I get some practicing beforehand, because I literally got my pad out the ball and I was playing with it and I was like, all my buttons feel weird. Like, everything just feels weird. My pad wasn't really broken in. So I was just trying to play and I couldn't even hit any links or anything. It's really weird. Like, I kept missing diagonals and shit as well. I kept like jumping up forward instead of up and up back instead of this and that, blah, blah, blah. Like,
damn, yeah, well, at least you got a new pad in the end, so that's a good thing. Yeah. The cable's a lot better, I'm sure.
So imagine saying ultra characters are toxic. Come on, man. you're just a boomer. You're so stuck in, like, Super or, like, AE because you played Guile. Like, you want
back
to go
in 2012?
When Guile was top tier, like, yeah, okay, man. Like, the ultra characters aren't even that bad, literally. Poison's kind of, like, annoying.
I know what God would want to run. He'd want to run an Omega SF4 tournament, right? Yeah, God, are you there?
Omega's completely trash.
Yeah.
Omega's completely trash. Like, Zugo's completely fine. Relento, people have issues with Relento, but that's because you're all fucking trash and you don't know how to deal with the matchup.
See my Omega Honda.
DiCaprio's fine. So, you know. It's just Poison and Elena are the problems.
Rango's got an Omega DJ. Right, we're on deck. Let's go.
Let's see the Smits. Kunai whiffs. Should have got a Punisher, but I didn't go for it. My man just commit. Oh my god. Mashing DP. He doesn't care. Alright, gets knocked down. Wow, just jumps over and backdash. Maybe it's trying to bait a DP. Alright, should be doing kick. Rare footage of a Buki player trying to play footsies. Gonna get a decent combo
here. Axe kick. Here we go.
Just went for the crashing jab into the fireball because she wasn't standing.
Yeah.
Well, gets knocked down there. Oh, this should be a knockdown.
Momentum chair.
Oh, I was about to say missed the Kunai setup, but guess it. Just put a slight bit of delay in there. Start playing in 2012, Pog. I mean, yeah, you start playing when like Guile was super good. Like, you know, no wonder you hate these new characters, like, and these new patches and all that sort of stuff. All right, creep gets blocked. That down forward light kick work doing magic for Ibuki right now. ESDP.
Working his way to the corner, but Bo just axe kicking his way back to the mid screen.
Oh, down forward light kick. Gets a full three piece there, the four piece even. Doesn't convert into the Tatsu though. Neutral jump roundhouse. I'm gonna go for the dive kick. That's my setup. That's my setup. That's legit. That's my setup. That's actually my setup. Nah. That's because I remember literally shouting at people all the time, like, yo, do forward throw, standing medium punch, dive kick. Yeah. That's actually my setup. I invented it. I actually invented it.
Are we going to see another late momentum shift here from Ibuki?
No, we're seeing DP. Look, it's going to end with a DP. Watch. And sit on corner.
Ooh.
Okay, I was wrong. I'm bad.
I mean, I thought it was going to be a DP at some point during all that. It didn't come true. They backed off and dive kick takes it, and you're into the third round.
Finish. Gonna get a knockdown here. What's the setup? Stand light kick. Nope, just goes for it. Automatic buffer. Slight walk forward, stand light punch into the Kunai setup. Empty low. Slides underneath. Doesn't get punished though. Wow, you're the command dash crossed up this input. Instead of giving him a back dash, you got a forward dash, which you got punished for. That was crazy. No forward attempt on the sweep. Doesn't get it though. Hard knockdown here. Time to guess.
Are we going to see Rem forced to switch character finally?
Thanks for playing.
I hate Ibuki, but she's adorable. Yeah. I hate this character so much. Especially in this game. Especially in Ultra. They gave her unblockables. Like, why? They're like, hey, do you know what? Let's add delayed wake up, but at the same time with delayed wake up, let's just give characters unblockables again. Like let's remove unblockables, but then add delayed wake up that gives more characters more unblockables. Like what?
Yeah.
I mean, at least we don't have to deal with Tammy unblockables all the time, but I mean still. Yun has unblockables, Yang has unblockables, Tammy has unblockables, Bison has unblockables, Relento's got unblockables. Bruh. Alright. So Sticking with the evil reel. Maybe Bo's just having fun. Just trying to play with the evil reel rather than his main shit. I mean, it's obviously, you know, nothing. This tournament doesn't mean too much. You know, we're just having some fun out here.
Yeah, I mean, it's around Robin. Maybe he wants to see how far he can get with his evil reel. Just because we're accustomed to seeing the Honda doesn't mean it's going
to
make an appearance.
He wants to wake up DP, man. That's what it is. He wants a DP. My man, what was that? He did like a DP and then did like a demon input afterwards. He did like jab into stand light kick. Interesting. Alright, that ultra I got imagined is going to be coming out soon, because that's the real only way of getting back into the match. Oh, misses a combo. Wow. My man did the focus attack before he DP'd and just held it. I respect that.
And Rem is looking on the back foot at the moment.
Oh, going to get punished here.
Go there.
Easy combo, gets two frame link. I don't know about the FADC, probably wasn't worth it.
Probably not, but you got the corner.
Oh,
focus, crumple into sweep.
Had all day backdash. Yeah, had all day to confirm the forward dash. We went for the back dash. Oh, that was not an optimal punish at all. Misses the two frame link again. Slides into the fireball. Oh, wow. Just, oh my god. Oh, it's a mess. It's all going to shit. Nice DP. Oh, whole lot. Stop crouch checking, asshole. Actually, I don't think that was a crouch check, it was a crouch jab. So unless he was doing inverse crouch check, which he probably wasn't. I think inverse crouch check is better with Ibuki because I think a crouch leg kick is 4 frames, so inverse crouch check is better because it's 3 frame with a crouching jab. So that's just like, you know, big brain tech. Quite strong. Back dash into the ears for the red fireball. Target combo. Ooh. Back throw. Gonna get set up from this. Empty low. Lands in front as well. Yeah, we're really trying to do that.
The XDP. Kunai saved him.
Slides into the fireball. Just, yo, my man just did fireball reversal. Blocks it again. DP, get off. Oh my goodness, that recovered really quick. I imagine we're going to be seeing the ultra, perhaps. Low forwards. Look at the lack of footsies. My man doesn't even want to try and contest that low forward. Yo, you know how easy it is with a Buki to press quite strong into EX neck breaker? My man's not even trying it. Yo, the setup? My setup? Yo, the setup worked. Yeah. Right. Charmander, if you're listening, bro, just stop trying to do the overhead, man.
Yeah.
We've already seen you land it like twice. It's not cool. It's not cool. It doesn't, like, it's not good. It's not cool. If you want anything else cool or good, Shush, please do. I'm dying. I'm totally dying. But the ES, that overhead thing is not working out. And it's not like the risk rewards in your favor either. It's not exactly a good tool. I need you to turn up the difficulty setting. You're looking like a 5 right now. I need like a 7 at least. Right. Are we going to get training stage every single time as well? Like,
well, who knows? I mean, people like it a lot in this game, right? The other traditional one is the underpass, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, there's like, every time I think of SF4, I think underpass is definitely like the only stage, because it kind of is. But at the same time, there's like 5 stages out of the only stage. Like, overpass is pretty good. There's one on the boat that's pretty good. Yeah, it's got a couple of decent stages, but doesn't block the kunai. Hard knockdown, time to guess. I think if he gets hit by this, right here, up, doesn't get hit. Let's say one more hit to stun, basically, there. Oh, dodges out of the axe kick. Could have got a punish from that, even.
Fair enough.
Oh, man, just...
Well, he went for the overhead again.
Holding forward. DP, get off me. Wow, wake up jabs? Yo, is that... Yo, does this man play SF5? The Abade? Oh, forward throw. Damn, medium punch. Does the setup? Yes, there's the setup. Yeah. Look for the DP. DP, he's going to DP. Why are you not DP there?
I don't know.
Alright, we'll finish off with a fireball anyways. Almost a full stick of power for Charmander here.
Is this
forward throw, what's the setup? Dive kick, there you go, that's the setup, baby. Now close to stun. Oh, get off me, yes, DP. We're seeing a lot of those focus dash. I was going to say FADCs. I guess they are FADCs. FADC forwards from Ibuki. Should be maybe checking the dashes. BP, get off. Doesn't punish it again. Oh, doesn't even try to deal with that move at
just
all.
Just axe kicking and jumping around right now.
Man, spaghetti. This is really spaghetti neutral.
Axe taking.
That might have been chip. Might have been. We'll see if it's a C. It is a C.
Okay. Yes.
Wow. So I guess the ask does like 15 to 20 chip. I didn't realize. Right. So a 2-1 for young Bo over here. Maybe my man is an SF4 player. You know, maybe he is godlike at this game.
Yeah. I don't know why he's on Eva Ryu so much, but like I say, maybe he just wants to try it out today and
maybe that's a secondary. Try not to fall asleep if he plays E-Honda, you know.
Well, he's got a fight Vertigo coming up, and we're used to seeing Gen versus Honda there, so I wonder if he'll go E-Honda. I mean, he'll go E-Honda in that matchup, or we'll stick to Eva Ryu later on.
Sounds like suicide, not. I mean, Eva Ryu can definitely deal with Gen, but can your Eva Ryu deal with Gen? That's the real question, yeah. Right, so could be potential final game of the set here. A fairly messy set so far. Not been seeing, like I said, a severe lack of a neutral
And we get the underpass, nice.
Fuzzies from Ibuki, as you expect from all Ibuki players. They can't play footsies, so... But, I mean, all you have to do as Ibuki is literally just press Crouching Strong and buff for a Neckbreaker. That's it. And if you get a Neckbreaker, you win the game.
Well, here we go. We've got pressure right now from Ibuki.
There's a win button. There's a win button right there. Wow, slid underneath. Right, what's the setup? Kunai, hit.
That's the conversion.
There's another setup here. Misses the Kunai. Still close to stun. This should
with
be stun.
DP, this dropper. Should be big, yeah.
Definitely should not have used the jabs there because completely scaled this combo to hell. Right, that was a cool setup.
Nice, yeah.
I mean, I feel like... I wonder if you could duck. I wonder if you could have ducked and then fuzzy guarded that. Because the Kunai would have hit late, I guess. You could maybe duck and then flicker between back and forward and block both sides. I'm not sure. Either way. Hard not down here. Time to guess. Misses this up again.
Stun again.
Another stun.
Gonna be a perfect. It's looking to be 2-2 right now. The same setup again, but...
Yeah, my man did the same setup and waited. I respect it. Bodied. My man got decked. Are we gonna see the free Honda?
Yeah, 2-2 right now, Honda. And it's Rem's choice. Is he gonna stick with this Eva Ryu?
I mean, surely Ibuki just can't Kunai set up free Honda if you just do butt slam, right? Because like you just go through the knife. You just go through the knife and be safe. Because I'm pretty sure Ibuki has some landing lag or a little bit of landing. Might be able to punish. I don't know. I don't imagine it's not great for E Honda, but we'll see if he picks it. Nope. This man's stubborn. He's trying to prove a point. I'm pretty sure I've heard this at a few high sessions. No, my Evil Warrior is good, man. Yeah. And then he gets decked, you know.
Alright, head into his next one.
Back on the training stage as well. Right, back dash out of the axe kick. Seen a lot, just a lack of neutral from Free Buki. Just lots of those down forward medium kicks just to try and guess when the fireball's coming.
Right. Just back and forth grabs right now.
Will you be seeing more of that Crouch Strong? Try and catch some footsies. Try and catch some normals. Yep, can't back dash out of that. Or FADC even. Ooh, that crossed up, bruh. Nice command dash to get out of the axe kick there as well. My sense here.
Keeps him in the corner. Slide.
Oh, back strong.
Overhead. Oh, misses it. Out. Been there.
It's horrible. Ooh, wow, DC cool. STP. Yeah, I assumed you could. I assumed you could punish a butt splash of Netbreaker. Oh, you probably did the same against like L4T, I'd assume. But you know, we're not seeing any Netbreakers even in this matchup. Quite strong into Netbreaker, man. That's what I'm trying to see. There's a Netbreaker. It's empty low. Sweep. Let's do a sweep into a walk up red fireball. Okay. My man did a forward medium kick overhead over a fireball, so. Dodging the fireballs with the down forward medium kicks again. Just really hunting for these hard knockdowns. I mean, as expected from Ibuki. There's a hard knockdown, time to guess. Blocks it. Forward throw. Misses that overhead because it was delayed wake up.
Switch to the other side. Grab.
Four bars. We're going to see the overhead. And
of course we're going to see the overhead. With the DP. DP again. And there's the stun.
Wait, do a jump cancel. You won't. Oh my god. He just did. Okay. Jump it into super. Okay. All right. So my man is not even going to try to do the super jump cancels. My man. You know, I did super. We should just use the ultra, man. You got no bars? Don't be losing. Don't be losing like this, man. Don't let this happen to you. Oh, no. Oh, no. Not like this. Oh, not Ooh. Like this. Oh, Stun. Not like this.
You've seen not so many like stuns.
Oh, no. Wait.
Wait. He woke up from the ultra. Let's go. Turn it around.
Wait a minute.
Gonna carry this momentum.
Wait, you could. Wait, DP. Oh my god. What button did you press? Why did you press Crouch Fierce at full screen? Oh my, you deserved it. Hold that L, man. Hold that shit. And you're a Buki's ass.
In a close set there, Rem's taking it.
You're
a Buki's
ass. Yeah, like Zane said. Yeah, you're moving like an urban squirtle. Yeah, my man's a water Pokemon. Bodied. He has Netbreaker. Yeah, you can't even do quarter circles, half circle backs. Yeah, get back in the lab, asshole. God damn.
Well, GG's all around, regardless of how grievous likes to put it.
No, not GG's. I'm disappointed, man. Man can't even Netbreaker. Well, you play the Buki, man. Come on, man.
All right, well, next up, I'm gonna save Vertigo Rem for the end. We're going to get Wonderhorse and Urban Charmander next.
Damn, that's it. Yo, Shaq, what do you think about that, man? What do you think about all that?
And if Scheming Fox can hear me, if he wants to come hop on, then come hop on, otherwise I'll come grab in a sack.
Oh. Get yourself a bus ass. Yeah, come on. Get my face in your arsenal, boys.
Hello.
Hey up.
Hello. I'm going to hop off and let you continue commentate last couple of games of this tournament. It's been hyped so far.
Get in.
Peace out. I've been Jack Steve.
Shutting up.
Screw bland blue. Bland glue. We're here. We're on SF4. Pog, pog, pog.
Pog, 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 pog.
Everyone we fire.
We got Urban Charmander with the Ibuki.
Everyone fire. Yeah, I respect it.
Oh, look at all those boss-ass emotes. God damn, I love that emote. Bless that emote.
Alright, so we are heading into this match-up.
Training stage. You know it's a real Street Fighter 4 game when we're in training stage.
Yeah, how bad is this match-up for Gal? Is it bad for Gal? I have no idea. It's bad for Gal, but I don't know how bad it is.
Yeah, I think it's more in Ibuki's favor, but Guile is still Guile, right? Like, he's still complete iron wall to try and get through. Like, Ibuki's got mixed, but, like, at any moment, Guile can just be like, nah, fuck you, Flash Kick. No, fuck you, it's my turn.
But, like, the Flash Kick's kind of bad in this game.
I don't quite remember, to be honest, with 4 Guile. I know he's not, like, I know he's a lot stronger in 5. Like, a lot stronger.
He used to be very strong in 4. But, I mean, he's definitely not a bad character in 4. But there's just certain things, like his Flash Kick not auto-correcting and stuff. That just means he can get really blown up on wake up. And also, just thing like he has a couple of things that are kind of attribution-wise, like FADC, Flash Kick, FADC, Ultra 2. A lot of people can't do that, which is nice. They got, but yeah.
Well, currently, Urban Charmander is.
Oh, there's the overhead again. We've seen it
with the super as well. A lot of pressure coming from Urban Charmander. You do not observe. Gonna have to put in a lot of work to turn this around.
Lands in front. Bar-bar.
Didn't even get to see an ultra.
Well,
not like this.
It's a perfect.
Perfect.
I see talk about calling me cheeks at Mario Party because Shaq's won one game of Mario Party in a game where I had one star at the end. I managed to get 4. And also, I lost a mini game due to like my alternating buttons not working. And also, Shaq had the lead of the game the entire time because I had to start put behind me by 2 blocks, then 1 block, then it was put on my block. So I couldn't even get the stars during the entire game.
That just sounds like textbook Mario Party. Yeah,
he's because he won all the free stars. Who got the mini game star? Me. Who got the coin star? Me. Like, I dominated the game. I just wasn't lucky. It's fair.
Which is like every Mario multiplayer game, right?
I'm not mad about it. Like, it's cool. Like, it's cool. But you can't call me bad at Mario Party when I won. I won. You won, but I won.
You won.
This man couldn't even win a mini game, man. This guy sucks. You know. This man literally couldn't win a mini game. We had to carry him. Like this man was dead weak. This guy sucks, man. All right. Anyway.
I'm so sad I wasn't there for that.
Back to 4. I mean, I'll record the next one. We said we might stream the next one. We might stream our Mario Party session.
Oh man. I need to be on that shit. I love Mario Party so much. Anyway.
This matchup.
Observe. Change the Honda. So it's 3 Buki versus 3 Honda.
Lots of
EX butt stomp.
Yeah, could have got a net breaker, but it's meant for a sweep instead.
Here comes the Ultra. Is that going to hit? Yeah.
Decent damage.
Follow up.
No headbutt punish for the anti air. Oh, butt stamp.
Oh, but butt stamp.
Oh, the classic.
Ooh, the Orochi throw.
Cancel the. I think that's forward heavy kick. Cancel the forward heavy kick. Yeah. Power frames into the command frame. Right, my man. Yeah, my man's backing up. I mean, to be fair, this is actually probably a bad matchup for Charmander because my man does not know how to play footsies. He has no neutral. So, like, playing against Honda, like, it's rough. Like, look,
we were talking about Guile being an iron wall. E-Honda's like the titanium wall, right? Like,
oh yeah, for sure.
He's real hard to get past. And you know, as we've seen in SF4 history, like, he can be put on the offense as well. Oh. He does have the tools for it. Over Urban Charmander getting that cancel into the super once again.
A nice anti air.
Yeah, really? Good trade. So we're one for one.
Yeah, all the meter's gone though, but I guess it doesn't matter too much. The matchup's extremely slow right now. Hard, not dying.
I did notice in the Urban Charmander's previous game that they don't seem to care much for like reserving their meter that often. Like if I got the ability to do a super, I'm just gonna fucking do it.
Yes,
fuck EX.
Like, I really wonder why EX Netbreaker was done there.
Hey, because the meter was there, right? Go use it. Ooh, that's gonna whiff. Oh, and slides into the DMs there.
I wonder if he's option selecting.
Maybe.
Because should be net, at least doing like a better punish. You could just do probably quite strong into Netbreaker, but doesn't matter. Anyways, gets the second one on the board.
Gets the dub,
mate.
Oh, sick dub, bro.
Gets the dub,
sick
mate.
Sick dub, bro.
Well, you won the war zone, mate. Get in the helicopter, mate.
Yes. Fucking love.
Shout out to Warzone. If anyone in chat plays Warzone, you hit me up.
God, I fucking love Warzone. I fucking love it.
Mate, Warzone's sick. I'll leave it out.
I haven't actually played it to have an opinion.
Pretty pog.
But Battle Royale game, right? So, I don't know.
I'm all for competition. I love it.
That was a frame perfect character select into training stage right there. Like,
oh yeah, no, that's
there was no like yeah. there was no like hesitation.
That's four. You just mash it, man. You just mash it. Flying.
Ooh, with the fancy shade as well.
And colors, literally ban. These have been banned since like 2010.
How dare you?
Oh, command
throw. Observe, do you have any honor? How dare you use banned colors?
Oh, misses the command throw.
My man Brad here, he will never use a banned color. In Street Fighter 5, when he picks.
It wasn't banned.
When he picks Gil, he never picks a banned color.
I mean, it wasn't banned at the time, isn't it? I knew it didn't get banned.
He never picks a color that is suspect. Oh, this man.
Like I said, it wasn't banned, okay? I didn't break the rules. I just, you know.
So anyway, Charmander with the pressure in the corner. Both mans sitting on the Ultra. There's the EX Orochi throw. What's our follow-up? Tries to go for a cross-up. Gets grabbed for his troubles. Really even on the life right now. I'd just throw the headbutt out. Yeah. I don't know why you're jumping for. It's 3x4. Gets the kunai and throws.
EX kunai. Bat. More that. She took her mask off, but her mask.
Yeah! That looked really scuffed.
Yeah, well, we haven't seen the Pog Champa Buki combo. Where are the dub? Where are the Tsunami loops? Where are they at? Jump back, Kunai. Hard, not down. Time to guess. Empty, though.
Alright. Jumps into the corner. I don't know about that decision. What's our follow up?
Yeah, my man was holding. You see that? Holding forward.
Observe can't afford to make any mistakes right now. Gets the EX Orochi throw. Oh. And another Orochi throw. Do it again. Oh no. Jumping away. EX headbutt.
Oh my god.
EX headbutt. Do it.
Charmander not playing neutral. Look at this.
Was my man's just fishing for Ultra for the finish?
I guess. I guess. I mean, he hasn't landed the Ultra once this game, tournament, because he can't do super jump cancels your ass.
Didn't he literally do the Ultra like 2 rounds ago?
Yeah, that one doesn't count. Yeah. Easy. Nah, it doesn't count. Nah, that was like off of like a front board or something. Like,
all right, fair. We didn't see that one. We didn't see that one. Saw nothing.
It doesn't count. All right, so 3-0 to Charmander, you know.
Yeah, good shit for Charmander.
Has it run into any Squirtles just yet? You know, well, I mean, other than Bo bust him up. That was free.
Yeah, I'm gonna throw this out right now. I don't give a fuck if it's like considered like normie pick, but Charmander is the best starter. Fuck yourselves. Of the original three.
It's hella normie, but like I agree. I feel like you you're trying to be a hipster if you say the other one. No, actually, no, I feel like Blastoise, like Squirtle's kind of cool.
If I was like, if we were like putting them in a tier, for me, it's like Charmander, Bulbasaur, just because it's a fucking dinosaur. Squirtle.
Bulbasaur and Venusaur, whack.
Like, but it's a dinosaur. Dinosaurs are fucking cool, Brad.
What, Bulbasaur?
Yeah.
Charizard's a dinosaur. It's a dragon.
Nah, Charizard is a giant lizard with wings. It's not even dragon type, fam.
I mean, it is if you get the fucking thingy. I don't know any of that. There's like that one. There's that evolution thing. I know he's fire and flying. You dick. Shut the fuck up. But there's a one.
Evolution. Are we talking about mega evolutions? Because I'm gonna say it right now. Mega evolutions can go fuck themselves. I'd rather talk about Street Fighter V than fucking mega evolutions.
He's a dragon type if he's in mega evolution, right? I don't know. I don't know anything about Gen 3. I didn't keep up with that shit.
Every Pokemon after Gen 2 back to fucking Street Fighter. Here's Vertigo.
No. Don't you try to flex with your Pokemon knowledge, you virgins, all right? Leave it out. Anyways, back to 4. Back to SF4. Back to our real game. Yeah? All right. Gen. We are seeing the free reel from Rem.
The free reel. What is it? Just anything that starts with that has an E sound to it is now free. Is my man just gonna like give him a grand tour throw like across the screen? Like,
oh, he went for the underhand.
Oh, DP. Here we go. Jumps into a combo for his troubles.
Oh, DP.
Oh, DP that cross up again. They'll be trying to cross me up, motherfucker.
Again, special. Wake up, ES hand.
They're going trying to get the pressure. Oh, that was nice. Saw the DP coming. Eat this ultra.
Why did I talk so highly of a game master? For starters, I don't even like 4, so I didn't talk highly of this game. Also, I'm not ass at this game. But anyways.
I am. I suck at this.
It's not down. Yeah, wow, just does a safe jump. Standard medium punches, crouch medium punches to hands. Just does the foco. Yeah. All right, jumping, medium kick, gets air to air. Cross up, DP, get off me. I imagine DP's gonna come from David. Nope, doesn't come out. Oh, wow, just walks into a throw. All right, crouching strong.
DP.
Very, very low life on Gen's side right now, but he does have all the meat. Oh, that could have been death. Oh no, that's what he's looking for.
Very, very risky Tatsu right there. Gets another DP! Oh, you are not. How dare you try to cross up Rem? He will DP the ever loving shit out of you.
Bruh.
Yeah, that reminds me of that fucking, what is it, the video with Ken where it's he's just constantly DPing.
That was sick.
My god. Holy shit, Virgo. What the fuck is this?
I wouldn't have got hit by it personally, but that setup was still sick.
Oh no!
Oh, wow. Crouch Spears. Why does it do like 160 damage on normal hit? Like, what the hell?
You. When? Alright. I've
played this game since high school. Damn, you're kind of right. Yeah, it's been that long, huh? 11 years? I mean, I haven't been playing it at all, like, competitively. I haven't competed nor tried in this game for, like, what year is it now? 2020? For like 5 years, 4 years maybe. I haven't played this game or practiced it for like 4 years. So all the tournaments and stuff that I've been winning locally and stuff like that, I haven't practiced with. I'm just godlike, you know. As you do.
Yeah, Brad's alright.
Yeah, I'm alright. I'm alright.
Yeah, you're alright. You're okay. You're pretty good.
I'm alright. I'm alright. I'm okay.
Alright. What we got? Inland jungle. I can't believe that Vertigo can't be the one on the sticks, because he'd be picking training states like every fucking goddamn time, surely.
I think he is. He wants a grand tour. He wants to see some other stages, man.
Hey, good shit. All right.
I do forward medium kick on wake up, because David loves to bat dash on wake up.
I.
The option selects on deck. Oh, focus. It's a foco. Oh, the double Ryan House, the two piece. Neutral jump fierce into the quite strong.
Gonna just pressure Rem in that corner, but Rem trying to fight his way out.
I mean, David hasn't got approach right now. He's gonna lose the game if he tries to approach, but he's gonna do it anyway. Yep, there we go.
There's the cross up.
8-8-8-8-8.
Oh my goodness. That's a lot of damage. Wait a minute.
Oh.
Not like this.
Wait, I don't remember if that's Crouching Reinhardt or Standing Reinhardt. I think that's Crouching Reinhardt. I could be.
Yeah.
Even it looks nothing like a Crouching Reinhardt.
It looks absolutely ridiculous. Does it depend on the stance as well? I'm not sure if his normals change based on the stance.
Depends on the stance, yeah.
Here we go.
Forward throw, what's the setup?
Get a toss, what's our follow up?
Well, the forward
tries to go for the dive kick. Forward dashes out of it.
Got that low profile on the forward down.
There's a sweep.
Oh no.
Oh, and Dave's sitting on a lot of meter. This is where he's at his scariest with this character.
That's it, kills. That's it.
Yeah, for real. It could be. There we go.
That was a lot of damage. That was a lot of damage. My man got duffed. A whole lot. I don't care if you got meters, bruv. Whole list. Random sweep. Actually, maybe looking for.
Rem gonna have to play really cautiously. Can't afford to let Vertigo get too much momentum, double especially right with all that meter he's sitting on. Cool, oh dear, there's the reset.
The overhand.
Get put in the blender.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Did he just go for a shimmy? I think he just went for a shimmy.
I think he did. Yeah.
He went for a shimmy.
Oh, there it is.
Damn. Optimal. All right, well, two on the board for Vertigo here.
Vertigo's so scary with this character.
I mean, I'll be honest with you, I'm not scared of it anymore. What?
Is there anything that scares you at this point, though? Like,
no, it's not. I mean, in fighting game wise, no, not really. I mean, why would you? What's the point of being scared of stuff, especially in fighting game? If you're scared of stuff, that just means you're gonna play worse. You know, Just got respect. You just got respect your knowledge and respect you know how to deal with certain characters, and you should be okay. Even a Gen is scary. Gen is definitely a scary character.
Only SF5 players are scared of Vertigo.
Get into the Zane. He's just chatting shit.
Okay, Zane.
My man just vomits. My man just like speaks toxicity. Like, it's okay though.
Sounds like a bunch of bullshit to me. Anyway, Solar Eclipse, best stage in the fucking game. Don't fucking at me.
Right, it is.
That fucking hippo having a good ass time. Right. Got Rem in the corner.
You know,
I'm trying to find his way out to get back in the mid screen.
Knocked down.
The cross up.
What's the setup? Cross up, doesn't get it. Was ready to block it anyways, I think. Jumping medium kick, crosses up with a jab, nice block. Sweep.
Gets the sweep, what's our follow up?
Forward medium kick again.
Alright.
Blocks it, doesn't get a punch. Wow, that was a very...
Oh my god. Combo. Even went for the red focus at the end.
I've never seen that combo right before, that was interesting.
Aye.
Oh, if I say land on a fireball, doesn't for some reason. Back throw.
A cool hacks on that. Here we go.
All right, jumps in. No anti-airs. Seeing a lack of anti-airs here from Bell. Need to get them DPs on deck, bro.
Aye. We saw so many of them in the first set.
Even just Crouch Fierce, man. Tatsu, back throw again.
There's the DP. He heard us.
Oh, kick again. Tatsu into the Tatsu.
That does so much damage.
It really does. God. It's because it's the air of Tatsu, so it does like 100 and... Wow. That was definitely accidental. He was supposed to do walk up fireball and he got DP. So
nah, he totally intended that. That was sick. Don't listen to him, Rem, you're sick.
I think he actually just like in the air does like 160 or 180. So it's like
yeah.
That's like 180 or something, so
It's also important to note as well that everything's going to look like it hurts so much more because both of these characters don't really have that much life. I think both of them, it's like 900, 950 life.
Yeah, they got super low health.
Both kind of just glass cannons, essentially.
Oh, this is the start of... Oh, it drops a combo, though. Super's on deck.
Oh, there's the super. Doesn't have the ultra to continue it, but still has routes available.
Thanks for playing. Overhead, but whiff.
Thanks for playing.
I didn't and land that instant overhead for playing. He's whiffing it. But is that it? Are we done with?
Yeah, I think that might be everything for SM4, right?
I can stop talking and grab some food and chill.
Hello.
Oh, good stuff.
Well, Jack being in call tells me that is the end.
That is indeed the end. Yeah.
Hoggers.
We finalized the placements. So thanks for watching today, everyone, and thanks for playing, everybody. We got in first place SMBF Vertigo, second place SMBF RM, third place Urban Charmander,
Pog.
And in fourth, we got You Do Not Observe, otherwise known as Wonder Horse. So yeah, GG's all. Thanks for playing. You can get the full results on our Twitter, and we'll post VODs soon of highlights from today's tournaments, Tekken and Street Fighter 4. And also news on any future offline events, if we actually manage to get those sorted, or future online brackets, which are open to UK. So feel free to sign up if you're in the UK and you play any of the games that we play.
So get in the Discord, boys. If there's anyone new, get in Discord. If you need games and like any games, Granblue, Street Fighter, Street Fighter 5, Street Fighter 4, Tekken, any of that stuff, there's usually people in there who are maybe around for games. Or I mean, you could just if you want to just talk about games, we have a bunch of different services about for individual games. So place for a decent conversation. And if you want to come speak with Toxic Zane, hey, he's in our Discord. He doesn't ever talk.
There you go. So GG's all. Thanks for commentating today. Did loads of grievers. Cheers for hopping on Scheming Fox and Kusage earlier. Badger, streaming as usual. All worked out in the end with the capture. GG's all.
Yeah, GG.